And moving on, it's Global Market Watch, the rise of cloud-based e-commerce. 我们接下来的主题呢是数据引动云端服务的新思维. Please join me in welcoming City Networks Head of Southeast Asia and Pacific, Mr. Jerry Chung. 我们掌声欢迎 City Networks 东南亚区总经理.
Thank you. Good afternoon, gentlemen and ladies. And then probably you guys a bit sleepy, so just do some stretch before starting. So I'm not a technical guy, and either I'm not the product manager. Instead, I am the salesperson who is in charge of Southeast Asia. And through this session, I'll try to share what we've watched, and then you guys get some clue, and then hint and lesson, if you guys are the members of e-commerce company, or if you want to do something on e-commerce industry, this is what I'd like to deliver today. And then also, it will not be, long, it's short. And then also, even we have booths in the first floor, if you want to talk about more, then come and then get some discussions or some free talk, whatever. Okay. So the CB Network has watched all entire global in terms of e-commerce and all the industries more than 10 years, especially in Southeast Asia. We just watched it more than 1.5 years. And there are lots of challenges in APAC and then also so many countries in Asia. But as of today, the APAC and India is the hottest region for the e-commerce. And upon our data and then analysis, Middle East is coming up. So this is what we've watched and for the e-commerce industry and the size and volumes and transaction. And the problem in the e-commerce industry is this is very, very complicated combination of the skills and even tools and all the services. So utilizing cloud services is one of the key factors to sustain and also survive and grow your business. Here is some funny things that you can see. So RedMart, the first one, is a Singapore grocery shop. They got funded from $23 million from investor, and that's a Singapore company. And e-commerce, this is some e-commerce enabler and platform provider in Thailand. They got about some $16 million as an investment. Then Luxola, even now merged by LVMH, Louis Vuitton Group, also they got huge money from the investor. Lazada, as you guys know already, this is one of the biggest and somewhat fast-growing e-commerce platform and service provider in Asia, right? They got already about $250 million as an investor. And Coupang, this is one of a fast-growing Korean commerce company. Recently they got $1 billion from SoftBank. Alibaba.com, this is, as you know, the one of the biggest internet company in China. They set up about $450 million fund to help the startup in e-commerce. What does it mean? More and more investment and monies are coming to e-commerce industry. The reason is, people try to buy everything in online right now and on mobile. Right. This is what I'm saying. Money is in e-commerce. This is why we watch this industry and trying to help them out once they just get something in visitors and also traffic, whatever. This is not the future, as of today. This is the top 10 e-commerce markets in terms of sales volume in the world, actually. Number one, as you know, of course, China. And number two, as you know, United States. Number three, number four, number five, you can see that, right? Question is, what's next? Of course, Asia. This is what we've watched. So this is, you can see by the countries, global, Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines and Singapore talent, you can see the major e-commerce companies here. Changing every day, changing every month, changing every year. They are evolving, they are some mutating, and then even they are making different business by the countries, by local custom. According to our research paper with Frost and Sullivan earlier this year, APAC by 2018 gonna lead all the e-commerce markets. China, of course, Korea, of course, Japan, of course, Singapore, and Indonesia, Malaysia, India are some key countries they focused on because, number one, they have well-established infrastructure. Second, they are fostering some cross-bordering transaction between the countries in Asia. And third, they have money to spend. As you can see, this is a bit quite interesting data I just got from some research. As you see, the Europe and then Central Asia, North America, and the other region, just incremental change of internet user by the year, very small, just minimum. But as you can see the next page, see that East Asia in the center, 44 million internet user increase. South Asia, of course, this includes India, 158 million in internet user increase, and even Middle East, 41 million, even Southeast Asia, 51 million, Africa, Eastern Europe, Latin America. This is the emerging market for the e-commerce target, and then also very fast growing e-commerce there. You see that? This is the focus, the red line, red circle. This is what City Network has focused on, finding out the customers we have to help there. Because the more internet users come, the more possibility spending money in online. This is what we've learned. This is another very funny and interesting data you can see. Even though really, the poor broadband penetration in Asian developing countries, but you see that the portion of the mobile traffic, as you see, very interestingly, Indonesia, 70%, India, 66%. Of course, this is mainly due to the poor landline and some infrastructure by fiber optics and huge land and continent and less coverage. But anyway, the fact is, the Asian countries are spending a lot of time in the internet by mobile. That indicates very clearly, e-commerce should be focused on m-commerce to mobile commerce. You have to find out the chances in the mobile using smartphone, and then iPads or some tablets, and then shopping in the moving, such as in the bus and some of your subway, you can do something. You see the global average, like some of developed countries in the below bottom, so Japan, Hong Kong, Singapore, mobile traffic versus the person, and then some of penetration, broadband services, you see that. This is like another data we can see very interestingly, such as active e-commerce and m-commerce shoppers in the countries. As you see, very surprisingly, even though very poor broadband and then even somewhat very focused on mobile communication traffic data, but Southeast Asia countries, they are spending money by m-commerce and e-commerce more and more and more. This is very, very surprising data for me because, on the contrary, the developed country, I understand because they have money and then their infrastructure is really good. They can access to everywhere, but very poor and the not good quality, even Southeast Asia infrastructure, they are spending money versus, some of the developed country more and more and more. So from all the data we've got so far, and then also 1.5 year Southeast Asia business, I just found that the e-commerce companies try to find out some multi-channels as of today. The starting from online, sometimes they just got back to offline. They started from online, they just set up offline shops because they would like to promote and advertise their product and services by the department store. This is somewhat like quite a weird and interesting one. The example is like Reborns, this is a website, but they have shop now in department store in Singapore. Mobile messenger platform utilization. Using mobile messenger and platform, they do advertise their product and services and they are selling and do share the revenue. And third, someone even that KakaoTalk and the LINE and some messengers, they generated some character and then also selling as an e-commerce on top of that. And this is a very typical one, but quite interesting space, as you see. Offline to online expansion. This is very conventional, but the segment is quite interesting. Online duty-free shops. In Asia now, like such as iShop Changi. iShop Changi is like Singapore Changi Airport duty-free shop online. They started their business providing online duty-free shop for the passengers who want to fly over to Singapore or transit. They just order in online and then pick up or the product in the airport, very, very conveniently. And then Silla and Lotte, this is, as you know, the Korean e-commerce online duty-free shop, very famous Chinese tourists, and then some Southeast Asia tourists, they just ship out all the product in the offline shop. Instead, they can buy in online too. This is another funny thing. Sometimes, in some cases, they try to expand their business by vertical. Such as you know, Southeast Asia countries, not easy to have some proper payment system and process. So sometime in Myanmar case, they would like to build up the payment process by themselves. In some grocery shop and grocery delivery, they would like to build up their own warehouse to distribute the offline, some of the product and services by online purchase. And the other one, this is also quite say the newly emerging one, personal merchandising service of overseas products, such as you are in Taiwan, you want to buy some, what is it, Samsung TV, but there is no channels, there is no way to buy direct from Korea. So there are so many websites who are gonna do merchandise your product from overseas and deliver to your site, to your home. Taobao is doing, so many Korean websites are doing, so many Singapore websites are doing. This is also quite interesting case, I love this. There is no offline channel. They don't do sell anything in offline, just do online only. Even I booked the Tesla electric car in this state, because even the electric cars will come out maybe 2 years later, 2.5 years later, but anyway, I'd like it. I'd like to have it. I'd like to get it, so I ordered that online. Tesla and Xiaomi. Of course, the Xiaomi recently, they changed their strategy. They changed strategy by setting up offline and then also advertising and propaganda, all the things, but anyway, this is a bit somewhat controversial business model so far. And this is quite obvious, as you see. Normally the e-commerce starts from domestic, but domestic is very, very competitive. So always they try to expand their business to neighboring countries. So as you know, the Qoo10 is a Korean-based company. They started from Korea, but expand to Hong Kong, and China, and Japan, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia. This is expansion by countries. eBay, of course, Alibaba, of course, Taobao, of course, Rakuten, of course. As you see, Rakuten is here. Very unfortunately, Rakuten Singapore has shut down recently, but anyway, they are trying. Amazon is same. And on top of that, to make more efficiency and productivity, they share basic platform together. based on the same platform, they share all the business practices and business processes, such as Hilton, eBay, Amazon, and Alibaba. And the last one, apart from the tangible product, now the digital service and product is getting more and more and more and more. So such as every marketplace here, they sell tangible product and also intangible digital services there, so much, really big. Even tickets and booking, hotel and coupons, and then some at the movie ticket, whatever, everything. And delivery by online and mobile apps, such as you see, if you want to have some, what is it, Sichuan and the Chinese food, but you don't want to go out, then you just use the app and delivery, and then purchase the money, purchase the food, and then they're gonna deliver that food to you directly. This is quite a some of the change and the recent trend we've watched so far. From that observation, we just try to find out, okay, what's gonna be the drivers and very important factors in e-commerce? Like even Samuel mentioned, and then the Google mentioned, mobile device, for the time being, mobile device is the final destination of the retail and the e-commerce. And then second, convergence with VR and AR, IoT, also key differentiator. Unfortunately, this is not essential, but if you have some convergence with other technology and services, you can differentiate with your custom competitor. And also, of course, this is very simple, the reward and loyalty and custom management is also very important. And efficient and secure system, web, mobile, and app, and also transaction management and delivery system is important too. But this is not a differentiator. This is a very basic, fundamental like factors in survival. If you don't do this, you will be dead. So that is the observation we've got so far. And of course, understanding customer and the market, because all the time, the e-commerce starts from the local and trying to expand to the global. So if we don't understand the local market, if we don't understand local customer demands, then definitely there is no second step anymore. This is about like some quite obvious data we've got. Let's say if your website, e-commerce website, just delay 1 second, then 3% of your sales volume drop. If your website load by 3 second delay more, then your customer satisfaction goes down more than 50%. Let's say your website 5 second delay in loading time. You see, the page view of the like your visitors goes down by 50%. That means your revenue goes down. This is like customer never waits for the slow and then very unstable website and mobile app. So the very, very important factor. So again, like the summary, how are we gonna differentiate your website and e-commerce, the product, price, customer service, payments, and we have to think about competitor, what they're doing, and we have to think about what offline channel is doing, and how we're gonna like the balance online and the mobile. But of course, mobile is more important because that's the future. But online is now, that as of today, so we have to balance. And then also we have to think about the value chain and how we're gonna install SCM using some Amazon stuff and the CRM and the vertical horizontal expansion. This is also the factors we have to think about. And the issue, another issue, this is a big one in Asia, payments. How are we gonna get paid the money? Even still the Indonesia now, more than 50% of the e-commerce transaction is by COD, cash on delivery, because their banking and finance system is not ready. So this is also very important, and then also interface with financial system and process such as bank, because bank is very, very conservative. They don't want to integrate all their system into the e-commerce provider because they have to change a lot what they don't want. This is another factor. And emerging countries, when you go to the emerging country, you have to check there is a payment network and gateway, some services. If you don't get anything, then the problem is you have no way to get paid, even you sell the product and online. Infrastructure, as you see, this is actual data from our portal. So normally the traffic is like this in your website. But if you do some events, traffic goes up. How are you going to manage this big change? This is one challenge. This is like the e-commerce website, just tools, and then all the gadgets and all the things inside in-store. How are you going to manage this? And online shipping delivery too. Like in Taiwan, 6-hour delivery, Taipei. And somebody, this is a Redmart website, and then there's some set the designated slot for the delivery too. How are you going to manage your internet infrastructure? And then also delivery, outsource, in-house. This is all the challenge in the e-commerce industry in Asia now. And finally, security. Every website has a potential risk to get some DDoS attack. And how are you going to manage this attack? How are you going to prevent? What if it happened, and then how are you going to manage all the things? So, issue is the choosing credible cloud vendor is one of the key. Seriously, because if you don't choose the proper vendor, you're going to be in trouble. And then the criteria for the choosing vendor, delivery and security services, local support and global infrastructure. Because if you want to make some e-commerce business, then you have to think about your expansion too. So the local hosting and global services, in-house or outsource, website, app, and then SEO, SEM, some other tools for the marketing things. Everything should be like online. So choosing cloud vendor is really, really important. So the City Networks, we are the e-commerce enabler, and we have more than 200 points of POP presence in the world. And we have a global reach, and then China and Southeast Asia experts in all the application acceleration product and services, security, and the cloud product and mobile CDN, we have everything. So the customers we have now, all the e-commerce, and then public, and banking and finance, and tourism, hospitality, media entertainment. So again, the final message from my observation is, there's a money you can get in e-commerce. If you want to make money by e-commerce, please do it. And if you have some problem for delivering your website and application, you can visit us and then have some consultation. So this is my contact and the company's information. And this is my very, very basic, simple profile. If you have anything to ask me, just let me know. Again, e-commerce is money and you have a chance. If you need some advice, come to me. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jerry. Now with that contact available, you'll be receiving many, many.